Welcome all. We are going to start our next lesson from 6th standard maths, that is the angles. So before we proceed, just tell me one thing, when have you studied about this angle? Yes, we have studied this angle concept in 4th standard. So what is actually the angle called and why it is termed to be an angle? Angle is defined as when two lines intersect each other. So whatever thing or whatever concept is formed or whatever the figure is formed is said to be as an angle. So before we proceed further, before we see what are the types of angle, we will complete this one table given on the board. So just help me out and we will solve it. So here they have given you two angles. You can see this is one angle and this is the another angle. So they have told you to complete this. Now they have asked you the first concept, that is the name of the angle. Name and type, these two things are totally different. Types means acute angle, obtuse angle and right angle. But right now they have asked you the name of the angle. Can you tell me one thing, what you can see over here? Yes, the angle is having a certain name. As you people or we, if someone terms ourselves by a certain name, same way this angle is also having its name right now. So we are going to see that. Here you can see PQR. Yes, PQR is the name of that angle. So how we are going to write it? Are we going to write it only PQR? No, we are not supposed to write it only PQR. We are supposed to use a small notation to denote an angle. It is called as angle PQR. What is the vertex of this angle? Can you tell me? Yes, vertex means the corner. Can you tell me where this angle or where this two arms are intersecting? Yes, they are intersecting at point Q. So Q is the vertex. Can you tell me what are the arms over here? Arms means two hands. So two hands are QR and QP. So we will proceed further and we will solve the next question. That is, what is the name of this angle? Yes, the name of the angle is angle STU. Can you tell me which is the vertex over here? Yes, angle, T is the vertex. And can you tell me which are the arms? Yes, we are going to start from T, that is TU and TS. Okay, now we will proceed further. Before, in 5th standard you have studied the types of angle. What we have studied? Acute angle, right angle and obtuse angle. We were not knowing that there are more types of angle also. So right now in 6th standard we are going to study 7 types of angle. So which are the 7 types of angle we will just record. Just before we start, we will just see, suppose these are the two arms. These are the two arms of an angle. Suppose if I keep them one above the other, okay? Can you tell me any angle is forming here? No, there is no angle forming here. So when this condition occurs, when two arms are coming one upon other, that time zero angle is formed. Which angle is formed? Zero angle. You can see the sixth one? Yes, this is zero angle, which is equal to 90 degree. See, two arms are here, two rays are present and they are one above other. You can see they are coming on one above other. When such conditions occur, yes, that time it is said to be as a zero angle. Why I started with zero angle? We will proceed further in that degree itself. So zero angle, by the name only you should understand, it measures 0 degree. Before we go further, we will start with our basic, that is the acute angle. So what is acute angle? Yes, the angle which measures less than 90 degree. This we have already studied. Suppose now these are the two arms. If we hold like this, you can see, yes, it is less than 90. Okay, so these types of angle are said to be as acute angle. So what is the definition? Yes, the angle which measures less than 90 are said to be as acute angle. We'll go further, that is the obtuse angle. What is obtuse angle? If we take two arms and if we just stretch them like this, you can see there is a certain angle forming between them. You can see there is a certain angle forming here. Yes, so this angle which is more than 90 but less than 180 is said to be as an obtuse angle. We'll go further. The next one is right angle. So what is right angle? Right angle is the angle which is measuring 90 degree. These are the two arms. If we connect them and if you hold it like this, so the angle which is forming is said to be as right angle and it is equal to 90 degree. For further we will proceed, that is the deflex angle. This is the new type, and this is the new type introduced to you also. So which is the deflex angle? Suppose if you take two arms. Now we will start with the next angle, that is the reflex angle. So what is reflex angle? Yes, if we take the two arms and if we take it such a way, for example, just here, it will start from 0 degree and it will just complete and it will come over here and downward part. So you can see this angle which is forming is said to be as a reflex angle. Okay, we have just now studied about the types of angle. Now we will complete the exercise. Later, the exercise which is given in the textbook is supposed to be completed by yourself. Okay, so we will just see over here, match the pair. So what they have given here, one side they have given you the measures of the angle and that side they have given you the names of that angles. So we are just going to pair them. And with me, 180 means which angle from here? Is it 0? Is it straight? Is it reflex? Or is it complete angle? Yes. What is 180? Yes, it is straight angle. So we are just going to join them. Fine. Can you tell me what is 240? 240 is more than 180, but it is less than 360. Which angle was having such a definition? Yes. So it is, can you tell me, 0 reflex or complete? Yes, it is reflex angle. Then we will see for 360. Can you tell me 360 means which angle? Is it 0 or is it complete angle? Yes, it is complete angle. And what is 0? Yes, 0 degree is termed to be as 0 degree or 0 angle itself. So we will go further. They have given you measures of some certain angles and they have told you to write their names. 360 means what? We have just now studied. Yes, 360 means complete angle. Can you tell me what is 90? Yes, we are knowing that 90 degree is called as right angle. What is 140? Yes, it is more than 90 and less than 180. So, it is obtuse angle. What is 75 degree? Yes, 75 degree is an acute angle. What is 80 degree? Yes, it is less than 90. So, yes, 80 degree is also an acute angle. What is 0 degree? 0 degree is also said to be a 0 angle. Okay, so we have studied the angles, the name of the angles, the vertex of the angle, the arms of the angles. Later we have seen the types of angle, which were the 7 types. And now we have seen the exercise related to it. The next part of this lesson is about the bisection of an angle. That part I will show you later. Just go through these videos. Thank you.